Hi, this is Kim Shanley of Tennis Reach with a quick tip on how to develop an awareness and build more strength in your ripple of power for tennis, even though we're starting off with a basketball and a medicine ball. In terms of tennis and this ripple of power, we say power is rooted in the feet, powered by the strengthening and the turning of the hips and pelvis, directed by the waist, and expressed by the hands. So in order to gain greater awareness and understanding of the mental model and how our bodies interpret that model, we have a couple of tools out here, basketball and this 8-pound medicine ball. So if you're training young kids, you might start off with this is a basketball, it's very light. We use a basketball instead of a tennis is because it does provide much more resistance than, you know, doing something with a tennis racket or a tennis ball, especially when we have the 8-pound medicine ball. You might start a young kid, you know, a few feet from the service line. We don't want to extend our targets out too far and make this too much of a game at the beginning, because we want really them to focus on the technique and awareness of the ripple of power. So even though we're using a basketball, we want this action to follow the map or the courseway of this ripple of power in tennis. So that means that we move the ball over our right foot, put most of our weight into this right leg, and so we start to feel this energy in the right hip area. And so the important part is not to put the ball out here, but to keep it close into this hip pocket of energy that you have and get down into your legs and into your hips. You really have to bend, and you have to teach kids how to bend way down with this storing up this energy down here, because they're so used to standing up and moving like this. So this exercise is all about gaining awareness as well as gaining strength. So once they're down, you know, with the ball over their right foot and most of their weight on this back and the hip crease, then we have a little bit of a dip, just like we do in basketball, right? Tennis, we have the same way. So we want the dip, and then from that point, everything starts from the ground up in sequence. You know, we start to rise, straightening our knees, and as our knees straighten, we want to transmit this energy smoothly into this rotating hip snap or scissoring hip snap. So we don't want, this is too slow, okay? We want this to be an explosive move. So we're down in here and we're going to get them to start the movement, you know, from the lower part of their body, but then we want them to snap these hips, rise. And so we want to look out for them starting to move the hips and the ball in the same direction at the same time. No, we always want to have this in a sequential time manner. Start with lower body moving all the way up. So you just might get them to start doing this first before this ball is moved. If they're moving the ball ahead or moving at the same time, they're doing it wrong. Okay, so I might have done it wrong there. So we're just getting them by keeping the ball here and starting this hip without moving the ball. And now we have this rising action. And as we start to straighten our body, then we start this snap or rotation. So they're down here with the ball. And then we just get them, we haven't done it at half speed, slow motion, then half speed. Then we go into full action mode and see if we can really get the dynamic of this snapping action as opposed to just a turning and rotating action. So we just get them to work on that and feel that snap, just like we saw in the Steph Curry long distance basketball shot. Looks like something like a tennis ball taped underneath my belly button. So what's this all about, besides being very weird? So in the martial arts, they talk about the center of our energy being down 2 inches below our belly button. So sitting right in this, above the pelvis area, it's called the dantian. So this dantian, in martial arts, they conceive of it as this ball of energy, and depending on how well we are at our sport, this ball can be very small, like a golf ball, if you will, like a tennis ball if you're getting better at drawing up this energy, or maybe even slightly a little smaller than a basketball if you have a tremendous amount of energy gathered up in this center that you're now going to express into the upper body and torso. So I thought it would be worthwhile to take a look at this Dantian point using the medicine ball. So remember, we're going to be turning down here into this, getting the energy into this pocket. And as you can see, as I'm turning, my Dantian is turning and is now located more over my right hip. Okay? So what happens as we execute our ripple of power? We start straightening, start turning. This Dantian energy starts to rise and then moves over to the left side of our body and then up into our torso and into our arms. So in fast motion, it might look like this.
So let's take a look at me in slow motion, trying the best I can to show you this ripple of power throw with the medicine ball. Note the dip or sinking of energy into the right leg and hip, and then the sequential straightening of the knees, and then the pelvis hip snap, generating the force to toss this 8-pound medicine ball a tremendous distance, or in my case, a few feet. I want to encourage our viewers to go back and look at our more in-depth ripple of power videos, including an in-depth look at Steph Curry's ripple of power. Yeah, and you can also get a good laugh comparing my layman's form with the exquisite form of Steph Curry. So if you want more power in your ground strokes and serve, start building your mental model of this ripple of power and start gaining an awareness of the energy flow as you practice. This isn't just about mimicking the external form or model of a Steph Curry, Roger Federer, or Andy Roddick. It's about internalizing that model into a real feel for how this works. Good luck, and let the force be with you.